Hello everyone, this is the demo video for the Simple Inventory Tracker spreadsheet. The first tab is the list tab, and this is where we would start the demo. In this tab, you would organize the different categories that you are going to use for your inventory tracker. Here we have a column for item categories, so you can add the different categories that your items fall into. We have two columns for attributes. So here we have the attribute of size, and here we have the attribute of color. To use this, all you need to do is delete what's already here and type in your own. So I'll delete the header here and type color, black, white, yellow. All right, and you can repeat the same steps for any of these items in this list area. The only two items that you do have some restriction would be the stock status and the shipped item status. You can only add 6 items per category, and this is because some of the formulas that we are going to use in this template are limited to only 6 items. And the last area you would want to customize is the currency. Right now it is set as dollar. All you need to do is go over to that cell, delete the dollar sign, type in your own currency. And once you do that, it automatically updates the currency in the entire template. And I'll show you in the rest of the sheet where the currency actually changes. The next would be to select the date that corresponds to when you're going to start tracking your inventory. To do this, select the dates, and that's it. And that's all you need to do to set up the list area. You could always come back here and make changes as you need to. The next area is the product stock list. And this is where all of the items that you stock in your inventory will be stored. Down here is the table area, and this is where we would enter information tied to the products that we are selling. The first column is where you would add an ID number or a SKU number that is unique to that product. The next is where you would select your item category, which of course you would have added in the list area right here. The next is your item name, and you would type in the unique name that you have for your items right here. The next two columns are the attribute column. So if you remember, we changed the first attribute to color and we left the other one the same. Let's go back to the list and we'll change this to size. And I'm gonna now add small, medium, large, extra large, and delete the rest of them. So now we have one attribute as color, the next as size. When we come back here, we see that we have color here, we have size here, but these don't correspond to color or size, and that's because I made a few changes to the list area. So now all we need to do is to select the correct drop downs here. So here we should have colors, which is what we have added to the list. So just go ahead and select a few colors. And here we have size, so I'll go ahead and select size. So the way this is supposed to work is that you will enter in the unique item names here. For example, for tops, you have a women's vintage denim jacket, and you have it in black and in white. So you would select the color, black and small, and that's it. Now, let's say you had another item that was exactly the same with a different color, then you change the color to white and enter the size. But what happens if you try to enter it twice? So let's say for this denim jacket, you've entered black, but you're not paying attention. You also try to enter black again. What happens? The color changes. And this color is telling you that this is duplicated. Now, this is because in the inventory list items, all of these items are unique. Okay, they're not supposed to be duplicated. In the incoming and in the outgoing tab, of course, they can be duplicated because the items are coming in and they're going out. But the list is unique. It has to be unique to the item, to the color, and to the size, or to whatever attribute that's tied to that item. So this would warn you that you have entered an item that is exactly the same. So you need to go and either change the color or change the size. So if I were to change this to medium, that warning goes away because now this item and this item are no longer the same. If you remember, we changed the value of the currency, and which is why we have euro showing up here. So if I were to go back here and change this to dollar, and we go back here, you can see it changes to dollar here and everywhere else in the sheet. All right, so the next is where you would add other things like the cost of the item. The total value of the item will automatically calculate. So this is something you wouldn't have to do manually. The minimum stock level is something you have to set manually. So how many of these items do you want to have at minimum? And this is something that would be different for each person and for each business and even each product. So select the minimum stock level that you want so that you will be able to be alerted when that minimum stock level is close or it has been exceeded. And the next set of columns are gray, and this is because just like this cell, it does contain formulas, and this means that the calculations will be happening in the background, so you don't really have to do anything. And right now it's empty because we need to add in products into the incoming and the outgoing for them to show up here. The next is a column for supplier, and this is tied to the vendor list, and I will show you how that works later on. Here we have a section for notes. All right, one last thing I want to point out in this table area is that you can filter. So each column has this little triangle icon that if you click on it, it will allow you to filter in different ways. It will also allow you to sort. So that way, if I wanted to see only the tops that I have, I would click on that, click in blank and click OK. And now the list only shows up as tops. The other way to use this, I'm going to select all of this so we go back to how it was before, would be to add a new item. So let's imagine you've added a bunch of items and you want a new item and you don't want to scroll all the way down. One way to do this would be to click on any of the columns. So right now, click on the item category, but it really doesn't matter where you click on. Let's just change it around and use color this time. Click on this. And now what we want to do is to clear and only show blanks. So once we do this and I say blank only, it opens up the next available blank and I can go ahead and type in my SKU number and the category, the item name, color, etc. So if I go back now and select all and click OK, you can see that it goes back to the way it was before and I have my next item showing up here. Going back to this area, this doesn't display anything because we are missing information here. And when we go to the incoming and the outgoing and make some changes, this chart will start displaying more information. This area right here is a graph that would allow you to display the incoming orders and the outgoing, which would be sales, for your shop for the months that you select. And here's where you select the month. So right now we have April 1st, 2024, and you can see it starts April 1st all the way to April 30th. So let's say we wanted to only display information from April 15th. So we would select that date here. And as you can see, we have information from April 15 displayed. All right, so we'll come back to this so we can see how this chart works and how this table works when we put in some information in the incoming and in the outgoing tab. The next tab is the incoming tab, and this is where you would record all of the items that you have ordered. Right above here, it shows you the top 5 items that you have ordered as well as the quantity. We also have a graph that displays status to order, ordered in delivery, added to inventory and receipt, and I'll show you how that works when we go over the table. And right here we have a place that you can display information, and I'll also show you how that works after we go over this table. All right, here's a straightforward table, and this is where you would add items. Unlike the product stock list or the inventory dashboard, here you can actually have duplicates, which makes sense because you may order an item more than once. As a matter of fact, you may order an item multiple times in a week or in a month or in a year. So we'll start with the order dates, okay? So put in the order date by double clicking and selecting the correct date. You can add the order item, order number here. And the date restocked is basically the date received. So if you want to use date received, you can change this to date received. However way you want to do it, it doesn't change how the formula works. So you can use whatever verbiage applies to your inventory system. So date ordered, date received. The next column is the item name. This is where the item name is displayed. Right now we have all these errors because we made some changes to the list and to the inventory tab. So let's go ahead and select the correct item names. So right here we have the item names that have been updated. So I'll go ahead and select the correct ones. All right, so now that we've selected the correct item names from this dropdown, which by the way is connected to this product stock list. So in this case, we have women's vintage denim jacket, black small, and the same item but medium shows up here as an item to select because we've entered it here as color small medium. So let's say I were to change this from small to extra large. Okay, if I go here, This gives me an error message here. And we have these error messages because we made the changes to the size of the item in the inventory side. So I'll go ahead and change it back to small, and then it changes back to small. If extra large was actually correct, we can go back and make sure we select extra large. You basically only want to change this if you made a mistake. You want to make sure that you keep this basically the same, but if you make a mistake, obviously you can change it. But then once you put this in there, if you need to add something else, go ahead and add another item with its color and its size instead of changing these items, because it's going to affect the information that you have entered in the past. So if there is a change, just add a new SKU number, category, name, color, and size. The next column is the supplier, and this is tied to the vendor list. And I'll show you how to update the supplier list when we go over that tab. You add the quantity that you received and how much it costs per item. So how this would work is that if you order an item on April 4th, you would enter the day. And when you receive the item, so let's say you receive it a week later, April 11th, you would add that date that you received it, and then enter your supply information, quantity, unit, and change the stock status. So we received this April 11th, so I'm gonna go ahead and change this to add to inventory, or you can say received, depending on what stage you are in your inventory process. And then you add in whatever notes you need to add in here. So now that we go up here, you can see that the top five items are correctly displayed based on quantity, and it's also in descending order. So the women's vintage denim jacket black, we've ordered it a total of 34 times, and it adds up each order automatically. So we have the medium, we have this 12 added to this 12 added to this 10. Okay, so that's how we have 34. And the graph here shows us the amount of items in each category. So how many we've received, added to inventory, in delivery order, and to order. Okay. And then finally, this is an area that would allow you to quickly search for information. Now remember, you could always search for information by using any of these drop downs to filter by whatever data point you want to filter by. But let's say you wanted to quickly display information. We're going to say April 4th, we ordered the jacket, so let's select that, the extra large. And once we do that, we can see that it displays the date received, which is this, the quantity added, 10, the supplier, and the status. It basically takes the information here and puts it right here. So when you have a really long list and you want to quickly display information related to one item, this is where the search box becomes very helpful. So if I were to change this order date to, let's say, April 1st, it doesn't display anything because we don't have any orders for this product for April 1st. If I change this to April 4th, it displays data. And let's say I wanted to see information about the order here, April 25th, I also ordered the same item. So let's go back here, change this to April 25th. You can see it changes the information right here. It's the same product with a different date. It tells me the date I received it, the quantity added, the supplier, and the status. And not only does it display it here, it also highlights it right here. So you can see right here, we have this grayed out to tell you that this is the item that is being displayed here. So if I were to change this back to April 4th, this changes automatically to highlight that information here while also displaying the information here. And just like we did before, let's say we have 500 items in this area and you want to quickly add a new item. The easy way to do this would be click on any column. Doesn't really matter which one you click on. All we're trying to do is to display the blanks. So click on supplier and we'll do clear all, select blanks, okay, and click OK. Once we do this, it takes us to the next available blank and we could easily add the new information, the dates received, the item name, etc. Okay, and if we were to go back, you can see that we have that information that we've added right here. The outgoing tab works exactly the same way as the incoming. We have the top items sold here. We have a graph that shows us the status and a little search area here. Here you add the date you sold your item, the order number, the date you shipped it, the item name, you would select this from the drop down, the customer name, the quantity sold, how much you sold it for, and you would change the item status here by clicking on the drop down menu and selecting the correct item status. And of course, you have a section for notes. And let's go over this real quickly. So we have the top 5 items sold. Right here, we only have 3 items displayed several times. So why don't we change this a little bit to have a little bit more variety? You can see that we have more items showing up here. All right, so now I've selected more than 3 different names. This changes to the top 5 items sold, okay? And it shows up in descending order. The kids graphic tee is the item that you have sold the most. And you can see the different statuses displayed in this graph. And just like we did before, we can search for an item based on the order number. So let's say we want to search for this kids graphic tee. The order number is 123457. And we're going to select kids graphic tee black medium. So go here, kids graphic tee black medium. And right now it shows the date sold, the date shipped, the quantity sold, and the item status. By the way, you don't always have to scroll and select because this might actually be a really long list. You can actually type in here. So I'm going to delete this and just type in kids. Once I do this, it only shows me this option to select. That way it's easier than scrolling through if the list gets really long. So if I were to delete this again and type women, you can see that it shows only the options with women. So if I wanted to filter down more, I could type midi and it shows me just this item because this is the only item with that keyword midi. And right now it shows no data because we don't have the right order number here. So if I were to change this to the right order number, it displays the information related to that item as well as highlighting the item down here. Last but not least, we have the vendor list, and this is where you would type in information related to your vendor. Select the vendor name, which of course you would add in the list area. Okay, type in your vendor name, the contact information, email address, phone number, whatever information you want to add here. You're welcome to change this to whatever matches your business and add the information tied to the header. And of course, you have an area for notes. And just like we have with the others, of course, you should be able to select whatever vendor and it displays the information related to that vendor, such as their contact information, email address, phone number, specialty. It would highlight it down here as well. All right, so now when we come back to the inventory list, you can see that the graphs now show as well as this table area displays some information. Before I talk about this, let's go back to the table area. Anything that has this gray color means that you don't want to edit it. It automatically pulls information. So the total quantity added is pulled in from the incoming and the total quantity sold is pulled in from the outgoing. The quantity on hand as well is calculated automatically for you as well as the stock status. So here we have in stock because we have a quantity on hand as 14. Let's say I change the minimum stock level to something more than 14. Let's change this to 15. So this changes to low in stock because I want to have 15 always as my minimum. And right now I have 14. Let's say I go here and instead of 20 and instead of 1, I'm going to say I sold 30, for example, just to change the numbers out here. So as you can see, now it says I have negative 15 on hand, okay, because I've sold more than I actually have, and it automatically tells me it is out of stock. This area automatically updates, so you don't really have to do anything to change it. It would show out of stock if it's negative. If it's positive, it would show in stock, or based on the minimum stock level, it might show low stock. So if I were to change this to 15, it changes from in stock to low in stock. That way you can easily customize everything to work exactly how you want it to work for your business. All right, and last but not least, we can also check on the status of an item here. So let's say, instead of this, let's select this one. The denim jacket black medium. So I'm going to search that. And once I do this, as you can see, it automatically highlights the item here. In addition to that, I can see quantity on hand, the total value, the date I last restocked it, and the date I last sold it. And finally, it shows me the stock status. So I can easily see all of that information here or I can have it displayed right here by selecting the item here. So if I change this to another item, the information also changes. All right, so that's all I have for this walkthrough video. I hope it helps. If you haven't purchased this template, of course, I will leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. My contact information will be available as well in the description box, as well as the first page of this template. Thank you so much for watching.